So let's go ahead and start a new song. To do that, you're going to tap this plus up in the top left corner here, and then tap on new song. So here, this is where you select the instruments. You have your drums, guitar amp, audio recorder, sampler, smart drums, smart string, smart bass, smart keyboard, smart guitar, keyboard. I'll go into depth in all of these in some following tutorials, but let's go ahead and start off with the drums. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is set the tempo. To do that, you're going to tap this star up in the top right corner here, and then tap on song and tempo button. And now we're going to tap out a tempo to play along with. So it's looking around like 125 was good. So let's set it to that. You can manually set it up and down by tapping these two buttons. Set it at 125 and then hit done. Let's go back to that menu. I'm going to talk about some of the other options on here. So this top option is whether the metronome is on or off. Let's go ahead and leave that on. This is whether you have a count in for your recording. So if it's on right now, we'll have like a 4-bar count in before it actually starts recording. And then below that is the sound of the metronome. Right now it's set on woodblock. I kind of prefer to use a hi-hat, so let's set that to hi-hat. Let's go back to that menu. This is where you set the key of the song. You can set any note along with major or minor. For simplicity, let's just set it to C major. This is where you can set this for whether the instruments will follow the song key. So if, let's say you started off in C major and played a piano line and then you changed it to A major, it would transpose that piano line up to A major so that it would fit with all the other instruments that you played thereafter. So let's go ahead and leave that on and tap done. Below that is a time signature. You can choose between 4-4, 3-4, or 6-8. Let's go ahead and leave it on 4-4. Below that is the fade out. That's whether your song will fade out at the end. And AirPlay Bluetooth, that's if you want to send the sound from GarageBand to some kind of Bluetooth speaker or something. Let's leave that off. And then below that you have your help section for finding out how to do different things in GarageBand. So let's go ahead and tap done. And so there's a couple different sounds you can get out of these drums. Some are a little more hidden than others. So you got bass, snare, tom, and then ride, crash, and hi-hat. You actually can get two different hi-hat sounds. You can get one from tapping it on the right, or an open one from tapping it on the left. You got the snare sound by hitting it in the center there. Or you can get like a rim tap by tapping on the right side, or a rim shot by tapping on the left. You also can get just standard ride sound there by tapping it anywhere along here. Or if you want to get the bell sound, tap it on the bell. If you wanted to do like a roll on the drums without actually playing it, you can tap down two fingers. And then the farther apart they are, the faster the roll will go. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's record a drum beat here. You may notice that it's not really what I played. What's going on here is that the quantization is set. So in order to change that, we're gonna have to turn that off. So you're gonna tap this star up in the top right corner and tap on tracks and go down to quantization. Tap on that and let's go ahead and turn that off. On this screen, you can actually set it to quantize what you play to either quarter note, eighth note, 16th note, 32nd note, or 64th note. What quantization does is, let's say you played a note that was a little bit off, like if you had a snare that wasn't quite on the two or the four, if you had quarter note quantization on, it would move that snare over so that it was right on the two or the four. And you can also set it for a triplet quantization or swing, which what I kind of played kind of had a little swing to it. So let's see how it sounds with a light swing quantization. Sounds pretty cool. Okay, I think I might just leave that on. So let's go ahead and tap done. I'm gonna actually show you some of the other options in this menu here. This top option is solo, so if you had other instruments playing, you could turn that on and then you would only hear this instrument. This is your volume of it, as you can see. Controls the volume. This is your pan, whether it's going to the left or the right speaker. This adds echo. And this is your reverb slider. This is if you have multiple recordings of drums and you wanted to kind of merge them together, you would have that on. This is your velocity sensitivity. So right now it's set on medium. I'm gonna set it on high and kind of show you what that does. Let's go ahead and stop this so I can show you. So if you just tap it lightly, you get like a soft sound. If you tap it harder, you get like a harder sound there. This is your bass drum with cymbal. So whenever you hit your cymbal, the bass drum will also hit. And then below that are master effects. This is where you can change what effects you're actually using with that reverb and echo delay slider. So let's try a different one. Let's do a rock and roll echo. And you can hear the difference there. Let's actually start this. Okay, sounds about good. Okay. So, let's go ahead and stop that. And if you want to get to the arrangement view, you're going to tap this button next to an arrow here. And this is where you can add more instruments and actually arrange your song a little bit. But that's going to be it for this tutorial. The next couple tutorials, I'm going to show you some of the other instruments and some of the other stuff you can do in GarageBand. Stay tuned.